Control. Here we introduce the Eagle software for the PCB designing of our robotic circuit, and it is an essential part of our robot. That is, the main parts are coming under the circuits, and here we using Eagle software for the design and development of our circuit board. The Eagle software is a computer aided drawing software that is developed by Autodesk. This is the control panel of the Eagle software, and first we take file menu and in the control panel and take new option and take going for a new Eagle file. Then give a appropriate name for our project. That now I am going to take the name that robot and press enter. Then right click on our project and our project undergoing. Right click on our first project that is named robot and click on new and going for first schematic. An Eagle file mainly consists of two parts, that is called a schematic part and a board part. Schematic parts are the visual representation of our circuit, like diode, batteries, resistors, etc., using the ordinary symbols. And board file part is the visualization of our board that we need to generate from the manufacturer. This is the window of the schematic part of the Eagle, and this is the toolbox of our schematic window of the Eagle software. And here so many tools are here. First, the essential tool for the schematic is the add tool. That add tool is using for add new components to our schematic circuit. That then we, if you want to add any components with the required specification, just click on the add menu or add tool. Then the Eagle software will go into the library of the Eagle software. Then here there we can select so many components from the manufacturers like Texas Instruments and other IC manufacturers. Here looking that these are the so many components under the under classified under like ICs, jacks, etc. I am going for a simple LED circuit. Here first, here is a search bar, then I am just typing LED here and press enter. Then here we can see the so many components named LED, like LED driver monitor, LED display, and etc. Here I am going to search what my proper components, that what I need. So just use the arrow button of arrow button in the keyboard and shift to other components. Here we can see the component. Here we can see the structure of our component in the schematic file and then in the board file. Here I click the LED from Adafruit, so then I can see so many LEDs here. Then I am selecting LED 3mm, that is, this is the schematic structure of this component and this is the board structure of this component. Then press OK and go into the schematic drawing panel and using a single mouse click, place the component at the appropriate place. And going back to the library, just pressing the escape key, then go into the library again. After adding an LED, I want to add the simple resistor. Type resistor in the search bar and press OK. Then we go into the Eagle library, and here I select R US resistor American symbol, and I select 0204 volt resistors and place the resistor here. And after that, I add two terminals for giving positive and negative voltage, that is by adding pin headers, presenter. Okay, then pin headers are not available, then press pin header. Search for pin header. Okay, here there are so many pin headers available, and select a proper pin header with the proper number. Here I want a pin header with two pins. Searching for our proper pin header. Okay, here. Okay, here pin header with two holes. Add the pin header here. After that, giving connections to these components as our wish, and press net tool on the tool from the tool menu, and after that go into the components and place our mouse pointer on the component terminals. Then we can see a green rounds on the terminals of the components. Press on one terminal and connect to another component like this. Then go into connect to the positive and to negative to the resistor. Okay, then our schematic is completed. Then we want to convert this schematic file to the board file. Before that, I will explain the tools using in the Eagle software. First is the info tool. The info tool is used for getting the informations from the informations of the components without just on one click. Here I just click on the info tool, and after that I click on the component. Here I have a window, dialog window, and in that window there's a name, position, gate, angle, etc., and the name of the library. All everything is here. I can edit everything of this component from this tool. After that, press on the show tool. When we press show tool and after press a component, then we the selected component will be highlighted. It is just to visualize our component. Then we use move tool. Move tool is using for movement of the component. Just press on the move tool and then our component, and select and move our tool. This is a move tool. Then this is a mirror tool that we using. Mirror tool is using to mirror the component, like just for visualization. It has no more importance in our circuit. It is just to get a mirror image of our component. Then we use another tool, is known as rotating tool. When we click on rotating tool and press on the component will be rotated. This is the copy tool here using. When we want to copy any of the component, then just click on the component copy tool and then on the component and place anywhere in the sheet. This is the delete tool here. If you want to delete any component, then just press on the delete tool and then component. This is the set change tool using in the Eagle software. Press on the change tool. Here we can see so many submenus: align, cap, class, displace, d-line, d-type, d-unit, etc. Through these submenus, we can edit the settings of the Eagle software that when we want to change the unit from millimeter to inch, here we can change. And when we can, if we want to get a high precision, change it 2 to 8, 9, etc. We can change the fonts here. After that, we use add button. I was explained that before. And here, if you want to give a name for our component, just click on the name tool and then press on our component. Then a dialog window will appear. Then just give a proper name. That give resistor, okay, press enter, then our component is renamed. If I want to give a proper value to a resistor like 500 ohm, then it will be 500 ohm. After that, we use another tool that is called junction tool. If I want to give any junction to our schematic file, I will explain like when I connecting this terminal with this resistor. Here, this strand cross over this strand, but Eagle does not make a junction at this point. If you want a junction at this point, click on the junction tool. And then press at that point, then only there will be a junction will be then only there will be a junction formed. And if you want to rename, give a name for our strand, just press on this name tool and press on the strand, then there will be a name will be formed. It an NS2. These are the main tools using for this schematic. Okay, we do not want this to this strand, just delete this strand by simply pressing Ctrl Z, that is undo, or press the delete tool and then on the strand. So we completed our schematic part, then we going to the board file from the simply clicking. This is the button for converting our schematic file to the board file. This is generate switch to board. By pressing that file, there is a warning box will be appears. The board C users Vishnu documents Eagle robot / untitled.board does not exist. Create from schematic. Yes, we want to save it. Then just press yes. Then our Eagle going to save our schematic and this is the board window of our Eagle. These are the components from our schematic, and these components are connected as our schematic file, as our schematic connection. Just press on the move tool from the toolbox and press on our required place so I just place these components here. Try to place the components in a least distance without any overlapping. Okay. Place our LED here. Terminals here. So we place our components in proper positions, then click on the root tool from the toolbox and select our component terminal, that is this terminal of the resistor, and connect to positive or negative terminal. Before that, we can select the style of our routing here. This is L and this is an acute angle. This is straight line. This is curve. These are styles. I select an acute angle style and place on these terminals here. Okay, that is completed. After that, I select in the another terminal and place root here. and I want to. Okay. Here our board connections are completed, and this, there is an important fact that there will be no crossing over between these routes, and it will lead to the short circuiting. So always try to avoiding the overlapping of these routes. And another important fact that the layer tool that I was not explained in the schematic menu, and this layer tool is used to select the layers for our PCB board. Here there is a top, bottom, pads, vias, unrooted dimensions, T place, B place, T origin, B origin, etc. Like there is mostly so many layers are here. The top layer consists of the components and roots for our top side of the PCB board. The bottom layer consists of the connections in the bottom side of the PCB board, and pads consist of the soldering pads, which are like this green color, and we do not use any vias here, and the dimensions are the dimensions like these dimensions using in the PCB board. Dimensions are the layers that consist of the dimensions of the PCB board, and T place are the components like structure of the outline of this component, and there are so many layers here. In our PCB printing, we want only top or bottom layer, pads and dimensions. First, deselect all these components, all these layers from by pressing none button, then select bottom or top. Here I use the blue roots, that means I use bottom layer, then select bottom, then select pads, then select dimensions and press apply. Here we can see some structures are disappeared, and here just parts and roots are here. Then press OK. And now I am going to zoom out this window. So first we want to declare what is the outline of our PCB board. For that, selecting the move tool and selecting on this outline and give. Place these at proper positions. And minimize our board size. Try to minimize our board size to maximum as possible. Okay, so this is our symbol board, and we want to place some holes here for fixing our circuit. Then press place a hole command here, press that holes for a proper positions. Okay, here, then this is our holes. After that, we convert this board file to a PDF file, and for that press file menu and then press print. This is the command that we using to convert our board file to a PDF file. This is the window for converting our board file to a PDF file. Select the from this dialog box, select Microsoft Print to PDF and give an output name for our PDF file. Okay, select proper folder and file name. That I select desktop and give file name as robot and press save. Okay, then it is going to save and select black from this checkbox, solid from this checkbox, and make sure that the scale factor is 1 and press OK. Okay, then our PDF file is generated and check at the folder of our output. Okay, this is our PDF file. Open it. This is the PDF file generated from our Eagle file, and print this PDF file in a butter paper or a tracing paper and go into the PCB manufacturer with this that print. Then the manufacturer will trace these lines and these parts into the copper sheet. Then our PCB will be done. This is Autodesk Fusion 360 for our 3D modeling of our symbol robots, and this is an advanced software that we can construct or design any kind of 3D structures here. And this software Autodesk Fusion 360 is essentially using for the 3D printing. Here first we want a basic structure for our 3D designing. Here I going to design a symbol robotic wheel that is using for an all-terrain board. First create select the create button, create menu, and then select a cylinder from the create menu. After that, place the cylinder at the proper plane on the window of the Autodesk Fusion 360. Then select the proper plane for our base for placing our base of the cylinder. This is the Y plane, this is Z plane, and this is X plane. And I've just placed our cylinder base on this X plane of the software. Okay, then place the center of the base of the cylinder at a proper position, and after that give the radius of the cylinder, that just typing in millimeter, that is the diameter, that is millimeter, that is I just type 50 millimeter here. And this is the base of our cylinder. After that, giving the length of the cylinder by placing here or by using this arrow, and place the arrow at a proper position. Okay, like this, and we can decrease the length like this and increase length like this. If you increase the diameter again, then increase the arrow here like this. Okay, here I use 80 mm diameter and 10 mm height for the cylinder. Here we can select, this is the a cube tool, that here we can select which face we want to edit, and this is the top I select. If I want a side, then just select the proper face from this cube. Okay, then I can, if I want to convert this cylinder to an all-terrain tire, then just first I select the top of the cube and I'm going to sketch a all-terrain tire structure here. First I select the sketch tool and select a polygon here, and I select an inscribed polygon, and then place the face for we want to sketch. Okay, then on the position, select the sketch tool, sketch menu, and then select polygon and an inscribed polygon from here, and select the face for drawing. I select the top face here, then place the center of the inscribed polygon here and increase the diameter and place a proper diameter, and by after pressing the tab menu we can select we are going for another sub menu, and here we can select how many faces, how many sides for a polygon. Here I going to select 5 sides. Okay, then press enter. After that again I going, oh no, correct. This is Autodesk Fusion 360 using for the designing of our 3D models. Autodesk Fusion 360 is essentially using for the 3D printing and 3D designing, simulation, and so many purpose. And this is the window of Autodesk Fusion 360. Now here we are going to construct a all-terrain tires of the all-terrain board. This is the tires of an all-terrain board. Here I will explain how to make a all tires of an all-terrain board and the tools of the Autodesk, some of the tools of Autodesk Fusion 360. First we select an untitled file from the new button here, new design, and select an untitled, and after that we start from a cylinder structure from create menu, select cylinder and select a face for placing our cylinder base. This is x plane, this is y plane, and this is z plane. We select x plane here and place the center of the base of a cylinder here, and here I can adjust the diameter. Then I type 80 millimeter here and press enter. After that we can select the length of our cylinder by extending this arrow and like this. I select 20 millimeter and increase the diameter like this. Okay, Then I can visualize my cylinder by clicking on the corner of this cube tool and click on the any face of the cube and drag our mouse like this. Then I can visualize. Then I'm going to select the top face of the cylinder like this. After that, I'm going to sketch a polygon for developing our alternate tires. Select the polygon tool from the sketch menu and select the inscribed polygon and select a face here and place the center of the inscribed polygon and giving the proper diameter like this. Now we are going to sketch a inscribed polygon on the top face of a cylinder for developing the alternate tires. Press on the sketch menu and select the polygon and here select an inscribed polygon and place the center point of the polygon here and give the proper diameter. And by pressing the tab key, we can select the faces of our polygon like this and then press enter. Okay, then we draw a polygon, and after that we again going to draw another polygon with a smaller diameter but with 10 face like this. Okay, press tab button and enter 10. Okay, then we are going. We want to place another polygon with 10 faces, but we should place that polygon with some calculations because we want to cut our alternate tire from the cylinder through these sketches. So that first we select a click a line and then place this line on the center of any face like this. Okay, then we are going selected, and then we again going to sketch a polygon, inscribed polygon like this, and place center here and press tab key, get 10 numbers. After that, giving in the here this line is going through the middle of the face, any of one face of this polygon and middle of this place. That means the sides of these two polygons are parallel to each other. Then we again go into sketch line tool and select this, connecting these faces. Like this.
Okay.
This is the outline of our all-terrain tire structure. Here, we do not need some lines, so we need to delete that lines. Again, we go into the sketch menu and select the trim tool and go into delete some lines like this. Don't need this line. Okay, this is the outline structure of the all-terrain tires. After that, we want to delete this alternatively, these sides like, and select, again, going to create menu, and select the extrude button. Extrude menu and select which face we want to extrude. I want to extrude this structure and place extrude here. Select that face. After that, okay, then after that, select this cube just tilt like this, and selecting this arrow, move the arrow backwards like this, then that face will be cut from our cylinder. Like that, just select alternatively these drawings, and after that we get structure like this, and then press enter. So this is the base structure of the all-terrain tires. After that, we are going to make a simple shaft for the tires. For that, select the sketch menu and select a circle and a center diameter circle, and place the center of the circle. And select a proper diameter. I select proper 10 millimeter diameter and press enter. After that, I again going for a sketch menu and circle and a center diameter circle, and place our center of the circle here, and I just give the diameter 15 millimeter, press enter. After that, we want to make a cylinder or extrude this structure outside from this drawing. For that, we again from create menu and press extrude and select that face, and from that we want to extrude it, just tilt like this, place and extrude like this. This is the shaft of the all-terrain tires, and press enter. Okay, through this shaft we can connect our motor to the to our alternate tires. So we want some holes on the shaft for placing our motors properly. For that, we going again for a create menu and taking for hold command, hold tool, and selecting the face, that is I want this cylindrical structure here, and I place the diameter, I can place the diameter, then I'm going for a 5 millimeter, diameter. Then so 5 millimeter, then let's zoom in, press enter. So there's a hole here. Through this hole we can simply place the DC motor to this cylinder, to the cylinder of the alternator tire. Okay, then this is our alternator tire. Okay. So alternator tire. And if we want to 3D print our alternators, first we need to select our component. This is the scale, select our body and right click. Right click on the body here. Right click on the body and select save as STL. STL is the file format using for 3D printing, that is stereolithographic file format. Select save as. Okay, then here there is a window will open, and when this under output, send it to 3D print utility. Then when, if there is a tick box, then untick it and select OK. Okay, here we select the folder. I select the desktop and give the file name. We select alternators here and press save. Okay, then my alternators were saved. And if I want to 3D print my alternators, copy this alternate tire for STL file format in a pen drive and go into the PCB 3D printing manufacturer and give this file to them. Then they will give a 3D printed alternate tire model. Use 8 software. This is a Proteus Design Suite 8.4. This design suite is using for designing of our electric circuit, as well as simulating our electric circuit. This is highly advanced software developed by Lab Center Electronics. For that, if you want to select start a new project, click on the file menu. I am going for the new project. A new project will be opened. Then a new project wizard will be opened. From this project wizard, we can select new project or from development board or a blank project. Here I'm going to select a new project, then press next button. Then will be a question there, replace the existing project and going yes, and select a template for the schematic, or create here we can select if you want to create a schematic or not. Then I just select the default, and from this schematic, through using Proteus, we can create schematic as well as PCB and also for produce a simulation. Here I do not create I do not create a PCB layout and click on next. Select if you want a firmware project or not. Now just I select no and go into next and finish. The main use of Proteus is that we can get the virtual output of our circuit, that the it will make our circuit is too easy. It will make our too easy for debugging of our circuit, and the output will be more and more accurate. Here now I going to introduce how to simulate an IC, that is a simple 7805 IC. First I select P and then select an IC that is 7805 from the search bar, 7805. Okay, then I select 7805, press OK and place here. 7805 is a voltage regulator. It will convert a 12 volt into a 5 volt, or any higher voltage up to 20 volts into a 5 volts. Here we apply 12 volt and this is ground, and here we can get output. So first we want add a battery, that is searching for a battery. I search a battery that is battery selected. Okay, I add battery here. It's a 9 volt battery. Next I just going to add LED, search, and from here I select an animated animated LED blue color. Press enter and place the LED here. After that I just want to change the 9 volt LED here and 9 volt battery, and from these properties I change the value from 9 volt to 12 volt. You can change the value from value to any volt through this edit, and connect these terminals. For that select the selection mode, select the wire label mode from this tool menu simply by clicking LBL, and then our mouse point will be like a pencil, and select on terminal and connect to this positive terminal and ground here. Positive output V to here, and then connect DD here. This then our circuit is completed here. Then we going to simulate our some circuit. Then here we are going to start our simulation. Place our mouse pointer on the play button. Then there will be run the simulation. Press the button. Then the compiler going to compile and animating. See our LED is blinking. If you want to visualize the correct blinking, just stop our simulation and go into add a switch, select a button switch. Here I go into button SPST switch here, press OK, place the switch here and just delete the wire, connect the switch positions and run simulation. Okay, then go into press, then LED is blinking, then when switch is open, LED is off. Like this, we can simulate every circuit through the Proteus, every complicated circuit, every ICs, Arduino, etc. Okay, thank you.